Hello, this is Mark from tradeinformed.com and welcome to this video on how to calculate the RSI indicator. The RSI is the relative strength index and it is a type of momentum indicator. The RSI literally calculates the strength of the most recent close compared to a set number of previous periods, and we use the RSI to measure and identify changes in the market trend. Now we're going to calculate the RSI indicator in the spreadsheet that's on the screen, and I've got some historic data already loaded onto the spreadsheet. So I'm going to start here in this first column and call it upward movement. In the next column I'm going to call it downward movement. And in the upward movement column, what I want to identify is that if the current close is greater than the previous close, then measure the difference between them. And likewise, in the downward movement column, I want to identify if the current close was lower than the previous close, then again identify the difference. I'm going to do this by using an if statement. So I'm going to say equals if the current close is greater in the previous close, then calculate the difference between these prices, and if not, then do nothing. And likewise in here, I'm going to say equals if current close is lower than the previous close, then again calculate the difference between them, and if not, then do nothing. So we can drag these down to the cells below. Now in the next two columns I'm going to work out the average of these two movements. I'm going to put it here, the average upward movement, and here the average downward movement. And I'm going to set a set number of periods. This is a variable in the RSI indicator. I'm going to start off with 14. So I'm going to measure down 14 cells. I'm going to put in here equals average, and I'm going to take the average of these 14 periods. And I'm going to do the same for the downward movement here. The cell below, I'm going to use a slightly different formula to calculate the next average, and this is the previous average multiplied by the number of periods minus 1 plus the current upward movement. And then I take all of that, divide it by the number of periods, and I go back into this cell, and because I've specified that cell Q2 is an absolute reference cell, I'm going to press F4 to make this a fixed cell. And do the same here. I'm going to take the previous average, I'm going to multiply it by the number of periods minus 1, and I'm going to add to it the current downward movement, and then I'm going to divide all of it by the number of periods. Again, I'll go back into this, press F4. Okay, so these can now be copied down to the cells below. In this next column, we're going to work out the relative strength. And this is simply the current average upward movement divided by the current average downward movement. And in our final cell, we're going to work out the RSI. The formula we use for this is equals 100 minus 100 divided by the relative strength plus 1. And I'm going to put some brackets around this sum here. And then we can copy these down to the cells below by clicking on the bottom right hand corner. Okay, so there we have the RSI indicator calculated in Excel. If you're interested in using indicators, technical indicators, to backtest your own trading strategies, you may want to have a look at my ebook course, How to Backtest a Trading Strategy in Excel. There is a link on the screen to get more information about this. Thank you very much. For more information about trading and backtesting using Excel, please visit www.tradeinformed.com.